Welcome to the tutorial on mastering creating the perspective and extrusion effects in CorelDRAW. We will learn how to create and apply these effects to objects. You can add a perspective effect to an object by shortening one or two sides of an object. This gives the object the appearance of receding in one or two directions, thus creating a one-point or a two-point perspective effect. One-point perspective effect is created by lengthening or shortening one side of an object. This creates the impression that the object is receding from view in one direction. The perspective effect can be applied to a single object as well as objects that are grouped together. You can also add a perspective effect to linked objects such as contours, blends, and extrusions. But you cannot add a perspective effect to paragraph text, bitmaps, or symbols. Here, I have a few objects grouped together. I'll click on the group to select it. To apply a one-point perspective, click on Effects to open the drop-down menu. Scroll down and click on Add Perspective. This automatically switches our tool selection from the Pick tool to the Shape tool. And our object group shows a grid of red dotted lines and a node on each corner. I will grab the top right node and move it inwards. Then I will grab the top left node and move it inwards and slightly up. Switch back to the Pick tool to complete the one-point perspective effect. A two-point perspective effect is created by lengthening or shortening two sides of an object. This creates the impression that the object is receding from view in two directions. Let's apply a two-point perspective to this group of objects. Select the group and click on Effects. Scroll down and click on Add Perspective. This time I will move the two top nodes inwards and move the two bottom nodes outwards and down. Switch to the Pick tool to complete the perspective change. After creating a perspective, you can copy it to other objects. You can edit it or remove it if needed. To copy a perspective effect, select the target object, click on Effects, and scroll down and hover over Copy Effect. From the submenu, click on Perspective From. Move the cursor over the source object and left-click once to complete the copy. To edit the perspective, click on the object with the perspective effect. Switch to the Shape tool, then grab the nodes and move them to alter the perspective as needed. You can also remove a perspective effect. To do so, select the object with the perspective and click on Effects. Scroll down and click on Clear Perspective. Another way to copy the perspective effect from one object and apply it to another is by using the Attributes Eyedropper. Select the Attributes Eyedropper from the toolbox bar. Make sure there are no options selected from under the Properties group and the Transformations group. From the drop-down menu under Effects, place a check mark against Perspective. Make sure there are no other check marks present. Click OK. Move the cursor over the source object and left-click once to copy its attributes. Then move the cursor over the target object and left-click once to complete the process. Let us have a look at how to create extrusions. An extrusion is created by applying a three-dimensional perspective. Basically, you will create an illusion of depth by projecting lines from an object. I'll select this artistic text. Then, from the drop shadow group, I'll click on this icon for extrude. Left-click and hold on the artistic text and drag the mouse diagonally up and to the right. Release the mouse button when I get to the appropriate point. This X that you see marks the vanishing point for the extrusion. It is the point at which the extruded surfaces would meet if extended. The default setting is vanishing point lock to object. Before proceeding further, let us have a look at the property bar. The first option is for a preset list of extrusions. Then you can select from a few choices of extrusion types. Next, you can set the X and Y coordinates for the vanishing point. Here, you can set the vanishing point properties. Click on this black arrow to view the choices available. You can set the vanishing point property to VP lock to object, or VP locked to page, or select shared vanishing point to share the vanishing point with other objects on the page. The default setting is VP locked to object. The next field lets you set the extrusion depth. Then there is a group of icons. The first icon is for extrude rotation. Here you can set the rotation of the extrusion. The next icon is for extrusion color. Use this to set the color for the extrusion effect. Under this icon, you can choose to use the object fill or use a solid color or a color shading. The default setting is use object fill. Following that is the icon to create a bevel effect to the extrusion by placing a check mark next to Use Bevel. You can alter the bevel depth and its angle by changing values in their respective fields, or use the Bevel Interactive Display window. Grab this white square and move it around to adjust the bevel depth and angle. Next is extrusion lighting. Under the extrusion lighting icon, you can have up to three sources of light falling on the object from various angles. I can adjust the depth of the extrusion by moving this white slider along the dotted line, or by entering a value in the depth field. I will enter 6 and press Enter or Tab to accept the change. I'm able to grab the X for the vanishing point and move it around to adjust the extrusion angle. I do have the option of picking an extrusion type from a predefined list. I'll open the drop-down menu for the presets list. From here, I'll make a selection to switch my extrusion style. Then alter the extrusion depth to 2. Next, I'll click on the icon for extrusion lighting to open the drop-down menu. From here, I'll click on light number 1 to turn it on. For this example, I will make sure light number 2 and light number 3 are off. The default setting for the light angle is top right corner. I will left-click and hold on the circle for light number 1 and move it to the top left corner. Then adjust the intensity of the light by moving this slider to 90. I'll open the drop-down menu for extrusion color. The option of Use Object Fill is active. You will see a check mark against the Drape Fills option. You can remove or add this check mark and toggle between the color draping around the entire word or each individual letter. Then, from the Extrusion Color drop-down menu, I will click on this icon for Use Solid Color. From here, I'm able to select a color of my choice to alter the look accordingly. The Extrusion Type field provides you with a few preset extrusion type options. Try out a few of them to see the difference. Your selection can further be adjusted to get the precise extrusion you're looking for. Next, I will select this object and switch to the Extrude tool. Then I will left-click and hold on the object and move my mouse vertically down. Release the mouse button when I get to the desired point. Before proceeding any further, I want to make some changes to the extrusion color. I'll open the extrusion color menu and click on this icon for Use Color Shading. I'll leave the From color unchanged, but we'll choose a different color for the To color. Now, open the drop-down menu under Extrusion Bevels and place a check mark next to Use Bevel. As you can see, our object now shows a bevel surface. I can change the depth of the bevel by changing its value in the Bevel Depth field. Similarly, the angle of the bevel can be changed by altering the value in the Bevel Angle field. Or, from the Bevel Interactive Display window, I can left-click and hold on the square and move it around to adjust the depth and angle of the bevel. I will click on this object one more time to bring up the rotation control handles. I can grab and move one of these green triangles to rotate the object. I left click and hold on the object and move my mouse vertically up. Then grab this white slider on the vanishing point line and move it up to reduce the extrusion depth. Or I can place my cursor in the depth field and type in the required value. In my case, I will enter the value of 15 and press Tab. You can also change the rotation of the object using the Extrude Rotation icon. Click to open the drop-down menu. From here, I can grab this big red figure and move it around to adjust the rotation. If I want an aerial view of this object, I will click on this icon with the circular arrow. I can click on this icon that shows the X, Y, and Z axes and open the submenu. Here, I can enter the appropriate values for each axis. In my case, I'm going to enter negative 20 as my X and Y values and negative 30 for my Z value. Then, I will click on the icon for extrusion lighting. Turn on light number 1. I will change the light angle to middle left. Reduce its intensity down to 50. Then I'll turn on light number 2 and move it to the middle right position. Next, I will reduce its intensity down to 50. I would like to create extrusions on the various parts of this table and have them share one vanishing point. First, I'm going to format the look of the various parts of this table. I will select all its parts and change the outline color to match one from my color palette. I'm not going to change the outline width. Next, I will select the tabletop and apply a fill color. Then select the 3 legs and apply a fill color. We will add the 4th leg shortly. Next, I will select this last part and apply a fill color. Now I'll select the tabletop and switch to the extrude tool. Left click and hold on the table and move the mouse upwards. I will adjust the extrusion depth value to 30. Next, I will select the far left leg. Left click and hold on it and drag the mouse to create the extrusion. I will adjust the extrusion depth value to 3. Then from the extrusion lighting menu, I will activate light number 1 and move the light angle to the top left corner. Then open the drop-down menu for vanishing point properties and click on shared vanishing point. Move my cursor over the tabletop and left click once. You will notice that the X for the vanishing point shifted accordingly. Next, I will select the far right leg. Left click and hold on this leg and drag the mouse to create the extrusion. I will adjust the extrusion depth value to 3. Then from the extrusion lighting menu, I will activate light number 1. This time I will leave the light angle at the top right corner. Open the drop-down menu for the vanishing point properties and click on Shade Vanishing Point. Move my cursor over the tabletop and left click once. Let us create an extrusion on the third leg. Select the leg and with the extrusion tool active, left click and hold on the leg. Drag the mouse and create the extrusion. Adjust the extrusion depth value to 3. Then from the extrusion lighting menu, I will activate light number 1 and move the light angle to the top left corner. From the vanishing point properties menu, I'll click on shared vanishing point. I will move my cursor over the tabletop and left click once. Now we will create the fourth leg. With the extrusion tool still active, press and hold the control key, right click and hold on the leg and drag the mouse to the right. When I get to the desired point, I will release the mouse button and the control key. From the pop-up menu, click on copy here. With the extrusion tool still active, click on this newly created leg to select it. Then open the extrusion lighting drop-down window and move light number 1 to the top right corner. Switch to the pick tool. With this leg still selected, I'll press Ctrl End to change the placement order and move it to the back. Note that due to the fact that we had shared vanishing point active, the extrusion on this newly created leg automatically aligns with the vanishing point of the table. Finally, using the extrusion tool, I'll create an extrusion for the last remaining part of the table. Change the extrusion depth to 3 and share its extrusion vanishing point with the tabletop. For further demonstration, I'll move this orange colored ring onto the table. Then, using the extrusion tool, I will create an extrusion and adjust its extrusion depth to 9. Open the extrusion color menu and click on this icon for Use Color Shading. For the two color option, I'll choose a color from my color palette. Open the drop-down menu for Vanishing Point Properties and click on Shade Vanishing Point. Move my cursor over the tabletop and left click once. Switch to the pick tool and left click once on a blank spot on the canvas. Now I will grab this object and move it to the right edge of the table. See the view of the object adjust automatically to align with that of the table. Likewise, if I move it to the left edge of the table, the view adjusts accordingly. Same thing happens if I move it and place it below the table. With the extrude tool active, I will select the tabletop. Then I will grab the X for its vanishing point and move it. You will note that all the objects that are sharing this vanishing point get adjusted accordingly. I want to go through one more demonstration. With the extrude tool active, I will left click and hold on this middle object. Then drag the mouse up to create the extrusion. Adjust the extrusion depth to 99. Next, I will select the object on the far left. Left click and hold and move the mouse to create an extrusion. Change the extrusion depth to 99. I will change its vanishing point properties to shared vanishing point and click on the middle object. I will repeat the exact steps for the object on the far right by creating an extrusion with a depth of 99. Change its vanishing point to shared vanishing point. Move the mouse over the middle object and left click once. Finally, using the extrude tool, I will select this white dashed line. Left click and hold and drag it to create an extrusion. Adjust its extrusion depth to 99 and change the vanishing point to shared vanishing point. Then hover over the middle object and left click once to complete the step. To clear an extrusion, select the object and click on this icon for Clear Extrusion. That brings us to the end of mastering creating the perspective and extrusion effects in CorelDRAW. Please take your time exploring these features and get familiar with all their capabilities. Next, we will learn about creating a bevel effect and blending objects in CorelDRAW. To do so, please access the tutorial on mastering creating a bevel effect and blending objects in CorelDRAW. Or click on the link provided below in the description of this video. To access the previously published tutorials, please click on the links provided below in the description of this video.